And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek, The Next Generation of Final Unity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. My voice is a little messed up. For the past hour and 45 minutes, I've been reading all the computer entries.
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
We are caught up with the next generation codex, as it were. So I'm not sure what we're supposed to do next. I am going to try to keep up on that as we encounter new stuff and, you know... What are our orders? They're just going to tell us to contact Starfleet, aren't they?
Any suggestions, number one?
We could contact Starfleet.
He's never said that. Now he is, huh?
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
Same.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should check our orders from Starfleet.
I'm pretty sure you said the same thing.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm not sure, Captain. Maybe we should check in with Starfleet.
Everyone wants us to check in with Starfleet. Let's check in with Starfleet.
There is no response, sir.
Uh-oh.
Maybe the comm relays are malfunctioning.
See if you can raise any of the local Federation outposts.
Hmm.
Aye, sir. I will try manually routing the transmission.
Okay. I'm looking forward to not reading so much. Letting these guys do talking for me. Rerouting? How's that going?
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Unfortunately, Captain, I cannot think of anything helpful now.
Hmm. Riker?
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't have any suggestions right now.
Data?
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
Unfortunately, Captain, I do not currently have any suggestions.
That's what he should say instead of keep telling us to contact Starfleet even we don't have to.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
Come on, Starfleet.
There is no response, sir. Captain, I have established communication with Admiral Redrick.
Excellent.
On screen.
Captain Picard, I'm surprised you managed to get through.
Phew.
The Romulans have disrupted communications through half the sector.
Those fiends.
We received the invasion alert. What's the situation?
Our information is still sketchy, but we know the Romulans destroyed Outpost Gamma 1-5. It looks like the spearhead of their fleet is in the Golder sector.
Oh, the Golder sector.
The Enterprise is at your disposal, sir.
Good. Then I want you to proceed to the Golder Delta system and report to Commander Chan at Outpost 543. She's coordinating our defenses in that area. I'll inform Admiral Williams as soon as we restore communications.
This guy sounds exhausted.
Admiral, if we encounter the Romulans...
We might be destroyed because I don't really get the combat. I mean, I think we can manually do combat, or I can initiate one of these offensive or defensive... configurations or tactics, as it were. Or I can just let Worf control it and hopefully he can resolve the situation. I'll probably try it that way first. Let Worf use his considerable skills at our disposal.
You're free to engage, but don't pick a fight you can't win, Jean-Luc. We can't afford to lose the Enterprise. Good luck.
That makes two of us. I can't afford to lose the Enterprise either. I mean, it's the only ship we have, and we are currently on board the thing. But thanks.
And to you, sir. I'm afraid we're all going to need it. Picard out.
Picard out.
Lay in a course for the Goldur Delta system. Maximum warp.
At least let me save first.
Engage.
Or not.
Warning. Entering Nebula.
Okay. Go save. Pretty sure we're on 18. And yes, I saved all my computer readings just in case. Actually reading, not out loud, but looking at the entries may increase score. Who knows? Set a flag somewhere, so... I don't want combat. It was
hard. Federation space.
It was hard enough with the first Wow, we got all this to go. Well, at least the light years are going by fast. We're at warp 9.4. Situation is dire. With Sector Lenore. Oh, wow. We're here.
Helm, standard orbit.
Well, we must not be facing towards the outpost. Can we contact them? Commander Chan. Commander Jackie Chan.
Greetings, Captain. I can't tell you how glad we are to see the Enterprise.
The hair is like, I don't know. It's like too realistic for the rest of the model. I don't know.
We're happy to assist. What can you tell us about the invasion?
We were invaded and stuff?
The first wave seems to have passed through the sector already. There were dozens of warbirds. We thought we were done for, but they just kept going.
They just kept going. Dozens of warbirds, huh?
They didn't even attempt to attack?
No. It looks like they were headed for the Zatarnus Nebula. We don't know why.
Okay, it is pronounced Zatarnus Nebula.
Are there any other ships in the area?
The USS Ayers came through a few hours ago, but they headed off to intercept a group of warbirds. The Klingons have promised to send us support, but...
But?
We've just detected some incoming warbirds. They're headed for Comm Relay 543 in the Pax Sonoma system. Captain, we can't afford to lose another comm station.
Okay. We're on our way. Caught out. Oh, I have choices, actually. The Enterprise is a match for single warbird, but any more than that, we risk losing the ship. We can't take on two warbirds? I don't feel good choosing this, but I feel like... Because I'm not confident in my abilities on taking on more than a single warbird. I'm not even confident in my abilities on taking the one single warbird. But, yeah. I'm just going to tell them we're on our way because, well, we have to assist, right? We're the only ship in the area.
We're on our way. Set course for the Pax Anona system. Warp 9. Engage.
Engage. Warp 9. We're close. Let's save again. Just in the very probable chance that we are destroyed, that I don't have to go through talking to Chan again. Save. Select the slot. Enter. Warp 9. 7 light years away. 5.1. This seems to be going slower. 3.2. 1.2. Bing!
Captain, three warbirds are entering the system. They are not cloaked.
Ah.
Red alert! Shields up!
Whoop, whoop!
I don't understand it. They're not even attempting to hide.
Could it be some kind of trick?
Possibly. Well, I have just saved. In real life, would not get to do anything over. Prepare to engage, Mr. Worf.
Prepare to engage, Mr. Worf.
Captain, the Romulans are changing course. They are retreating.
Retreating? What the hell? Change course to intercept.
Helm, change course to intercept. It's time we found out what they're up to.
Sir, one of the warbirds is breaking formation. It is turning to engage us. A Romulan warbird is on sensors.
Targeting Romulan...
Mr. Worf, you have tactical.
Captain.
Mr. Worf.
I am honored.
Heh.
We have the hit. Torpedo locked. Enemy ship with the shields are holding.
Targeting Romulan warbird.
Are they still there? Oh, there they are. Ouch.
A
Attention, Romulan vessel. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise.
Are we surrendering? It looked like we got hit pretty badly there.
I am Tyrilak, commander of the Imperial Warbird Psionex.
Ooh, a cool name.
Your ship is crippled, Tyrilak. I'm offering to beam you and your crew aboard the Enterprise. You will be well treated.
Cool. Well, that was easy. Way to go, Worf.
No doubt. Unfortunately, we will not be able to accept your generous offer.
Oh?
Captain, energy emissions from the Psionex are rapidly increasing. I believe they have activated their self-destruct system.
Oh boy. You guys and your harakiri lifestyle.
Helm, back us off. I don't want us anywhere near that ship when it goes.
That's exactly the second thing I was thinking. Why did your ships cross the neutral zone? Doesn't have to end like this. Or farewell, Commander. It's a little late to ask them this. Let's just say it doesn't have to end like this.
It doesn't have to end like this, Tyrilak.
I really doubt they'd give us information right before exploding, so I'll choose this.
For us, there is no other way, Picard.
Huh. What a fool's mission.
You know, you fight like a Romulan. Perhaps now, I can show you how to die like one.
Well, you're gonna attack again before you blow up? Or not?
The Romulan warbird has been destroyed.
Okay.
Alert canceled. Condition green.
Cool. Back to bridge.
Mr. Data, give me a scan of this sector.
Hmm.
Yes, sir. No unusual readings.
Good work.
Agreed.
Agreed that it was good work? Yeah, Data's awesome. That was successful. So let's update our save here. Now what? Where the hell are we again? Golder sector? Let's talk to Chan again.
What do you have to report, Captain?
One destroyed Romulan vessel.
The relay station has been secured. We defeated one of the warbirds, but unfortunately the Romulans destroyed themselves to avoid capture.
The fools.
The Romulans have a strange conception of honor.
Aye.
Well, there's no time to dwell on that. I have another assignment for you.
Who are you to order me around? I'm Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the USS Enterprise. We probably are in need of repairs.
We're in need of some repairs.
There's no time. We've just received a communication from a Klingon attack cruiser in the Bayless system.
Ah, damn it.
They reported engaging three warbirds headed for this outpost. Give the Klingons any assistance they need, and make sure those warbirds don't get through.
I'll try.
Three warbirds. We're on our way. Lay in a course for the Ballast system. Warp 9.
Engage.
Engage.
I said first, Picard. I'm going to be saving over, guys, because I am not confident right now in anything. At least we're rather close. 5.5 light years. Now I keep having to delegate Worf. I thought he would automatically be... Because I've delegated it before, I think.
We are receiving a message from Captain Ky'Dra of the Bortas.
Mm-hmm.
The Bortas was one of the first Klingon ships to offer assistance when the Romulan invasion began.
Well, that's very nice of them. For Klingons, especially.
Captain Ky'Dra fought with me against the Duras. He is a warrior of great courage.
He fought with great honor.
Put him on screen. Greetings, Captain. This is Jean-Luc Picard of the Enterprise.
Captain Picard, it is an honor.
I love the Klingons.
The honor is mine. Lieutenant Worf speaks very highly of you.
His eyebrows raise.
As well he should. We crushed many enemies together.
Awesome.
Well, I bear good news, Captain. We have saved one of your communication relays from a Romulan attack.
Oh, thank you, Bortas.
Then we are in your debt. Do you require any assistance with your ship or crew?
None whatsoever. We were completely unscathed.
Well done.
And, Captain, we captured a warbird and many prisoners. It was a truly glorious victory.
Wow, you got them before they could do the self-destruct maneuver, huh?
You captured a Romulan warbird without any resistance?
They had little to resist us with.
Huh. What about all this refitting they had?
When we boarded their ship, we found that it had been severely modified, stripped of most weapons and many other systems as well.
Yeah, that's right. They were saying something like that, and when I was reading the articles last episode, it said that they had refitted their ships for more defensive or speed rather than offensive. Which is strange. Why would they strip their weapons just for speed? Who are they trying to outrun? Can't be just the Federation. What are they up to?
Why would they purposely make themselves so vulnerable?
Yeah.
The modifications nearly doubled their engine power. It seems they were willing to sacrifice weapons for speed.
Well, that's exactly what the hell I was talking about.
Captain, such modifications would have placed extreme stresses on the warbird's hull. It would not have survived an extended mission.
As always, Data speaks with great logic.
Maybe they never expected to survive. Maybe they were on a suicide mission.
Really? Yeah. I mean, that explains... I mean, it is the Romulan way to self-destruct so as we don't get a hold of their technology. But maybe that's why they were so quick to do so. I guess we crippled their engines. So like, well, our speed's gone, we have just about nothing left. Might as well blow ourselves up then.
But a suicide mission for what?
Exactly.
During our interrogations, the prisoners mentioned a weapon of some kind. Perhaps that is what they were seeking.
All this to find some kind of a weapon. So they get rid of all their other weapons to find one great weapon from whom? What exactly did you learn from the prisoners, I guess, other than what you just told us?
What exactly did you learn from the prisoners?
They spoke of an ancient weapon, a relic of a long-dead race known as the Chodak.
Right?
A weapon of ultimate power which would solve all their problems, put an end to their war, and destroy both the Federation and the Klingon Empire.
We do not want them getting a hold of that.
You sound as if you don't believe this weapon exists.
I bet it does.
It is nothing more than a desperate fantasy. According to our reports, their empire will soon be overrun by alien invaders. The Romulans are clutching for anything they think can save them.
The Empire? The Romulan Empire will be overrun by alien invaders? What alien invaders?
Assuming the weapon is real, how did the Romulans expect to find it?
Apparently, they found clues to the weapon's supposed location at the site of some Chodak ruins. Now they're wasting valuable ships on a useless quest while their empire burns. Fools.
Interesting. Can you tell us anything else about the Romulans' war?
Can you tell us anything else about the Romulans' war?
They are fighting a formidable adversary. Extremely powerful aliens from the far side of their empire. We know nothing more than that.
Can't be fighting this Chodak, can they? I mean... whoever's watching this, please don't tell me I'm just wondering aloud. Trying to figure out what's going on here.
With your permission, I'd like to question the Romulan commander myself. I can beam over immediately.
Interesting idea. course, I do trust this Klingon as much as I can trust any Klingon besides, well, our own Lieutenant Worf, that is. He seems to have great honor.
I'm afraid that won't be possible. The commander is presently... indisposed. Perhaps permanently.
Oh. Does that mean dead? I'm not sure if he'd appreciate us questioning his appropriate handling of prisoners. Tell me about the battle.
Tell me about the battle.
We were on patrol in the ballast system near your relay station when we detected three warbirds approaching rapidly.
Right, similar situation to our own a few minutes ago.
You engaged three warbirds with a single ship.
Let me guess, two retreated.
I wouldn't care to face those odds even in the Enterprise.
We were ready for an honorable death as we closed with their lead ship. We locked our disruptors, prepared to fire.
And
they fled.
Yeah.
The cowards ran from us, even though they held the advantage.
So you pursued?
They didn't even attempt to attack the station?
They were concerned only with escape. By the time we disabled their first ship, the other two were already out of range.
You must have acted quickly, either that or disabled, whatever controls their self-destruct mechanism.
Were you able to track them?
Disabled their computers, I guess.
Yes, for a while. We believe they were heading for the Zatanna's Nebula.
Mm-hmm. Kapla! yeah, let me ask him this. Let's hope this isn't incorrect. Trust you are handling the prisoners appropriately?
I trust that you are handling the prisoners appropriately.
Of course, appropriately is up to debate.
Of course, but several of them are still alive.
Yes, he is answering as appropriately the Klingon way, which I expected he would.
Captain, I'd like to respectfully remind you that you are in Federation space, and as such, you're expected to conform to Federation rules of conduct, including the proper treatment of prisoners.
Hmm. Fully in the Paragon, mode here.
They have been given the proper treatment that Romulans deserve.
Yes. They deserve no less.
Perhaps it would be better for all concerned if you released the prisoners into our custody instead.
Oh God, Picard, I didn't want to go this far into it.
This is a Klingon matter, Picard. It is none of your concern. If our methods are so distasteful to you, perhaps next time the Federation can defend itself without our help. Ky'Dra, out.
That's what I was afraid of. But wait, 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 Kapla! Aye, aye, aye. Commander Chan, so
what could the Romulans be up to?
Let's save.
They are not eager to fight. Their actions seem somewhat desperate.
Indeed.
I'm beginning to wonder if this really is an invasion after all.
Yeah, it's really a ploy, a tactic to distract us, perhaps?
According to the information provided by Captain Ky'Dra, the modifications to the warbirds will render the ships unusable within a few weeks. That would seem inconsistent with the needs of a long-term occupational force.
Yeah, there's no seam about it.
But they made those modifications for a reason. Speed. It looks like they're trying to get to the Zatarnus Nebula as fast as they can.
So I'm guessing we're going to automatically head for the Zatarnus Nebula at this point.
Agreed. The question is, why?
Or maybe not. Let's save. Well, we still can. Let's contact Starfleet.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
Oh, glad we were able to get through this time.
What is the current situation, Admiral?
The Romulans have invaded Federation space. Our information is still sketchy, but there have been reports of attacks and multiple warbird sightings in several sectors.
Hmm. Current orders?
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. You're to report back to Outpost 543 in the Golda Delta system for your next assignment.
Are we still there? I'm not even sure. Assessment?
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
I'm pleased to note that you contacted the Klingon attack cruiser Bortas, which intercepted and diverted a squadron of warbirds.
Yeah, and unfortunately screwed up and asked him something. I chose that one line and Picard just kept going, didn't he?
Captain Ky'Dra was able to take prisoners and obtain some valuable information about the reasons for the Romulan invasion.
Yes. Now, can you tell us anything we don't know?
Shall I go on?
That doesn't really tell us about our performance.
Please do.
Let's just see.
Very impressive, Jean-Luc. The Enterprise successfully defended Comm Relay 543 and defeated a warbird in the process. The Romulans will remember this for some time.
And well, they should.
Shall I go on?
Sure.
Please do.
Starfleet Command is very pleased with your first contact mission to the Garidian colony on Phrygis. However, the subsequent discovery of the fifth scroll will have profound effects on Garrod. I commend you on your handling of the Garidian refugee problem. Tabak, Lucana, and Avakar have returned home aboard the Garidian warbird Asirum. Their intrusion into Federation space has been handled through diplomatic channels.
Yeah, we've actually heard all that before.
Shall I go on?
No.
No, thank you.
So we're supposed to head for...
I'd like to...
Of course. You're to report back to Outpost 54...
543. Commander Chan, right?
Picard out.
Captain, what do you have to report?
The Bortas chased off the warbirds.
One Klingon ship chased off three warbirds?
Yep. Then one Klingon captain pissed them off.
Not only that, it disabled and captured one of them.
I think I'll send Captain Ky'Dra a bottle of Saurian brandy along with my thanks.
Yes, and please send him my apologies as well.
He certainly earned it. According to his prisoners, the Romulans are not interested in invading the Federation, at least not yet. Apparently they're heading for the Zatannis Nebula.
That nebula has no strategic value. What are they looking for?
Unknown.
We believe they're seeking an ancient weapon built by the Chodak.
Oh yeah, unknown except for that.
The Chodak?
Yeah, perhaps you've heard of them? Ancient spacefaring race?
I've heard the stories. Some kind of star-eating superweapon hidden in the nebula. But they're just stories. The Romulans wouldn't risk war over a myth.
Oh. So there is some truth to the Star Eater, which is not a creature that eats stars, but is a super weapon in the nebula, probably created by the Chodak, which the Romulans are seeking.
But the Romulans never do anything without considering all the consequences. Perhaps there's more truth to these stories than we realized.
There has to be, or at least they think there is.
All right, Captain. A pair of Klingon attack cruisers have just arrived in the sector to support us. I think we can manage without you. If you want to investigate this Chodak weapon further, you're free to do so.
Well, thanks. I'm glad we have your permission.
Thank you, Commander. I intend to get to the bottom of this.
Sir, we are receiving a signal from Starfleet. It is Admiral Williams.
Ah, new orders, I suppose? Ignore that. On screen.
On screen. Greetings, Admiral. What can we do for you?
Captain, Commander Chan notified us of your findings. Your suspicions that this was not a full-scale invasion appear to be correct.
I
know. The Romulan incursion appears to be limited to the sectors between the Neutral Zone and the Zatannis Nebula.
We must find out what they're really after.
Indeed, Captain.
Agreed. The recurring thread through all this seems to be the Chodak. Do you have any ideas where to begin?
Most of the surviving Chodak ruins are in Romulan space. However, we recently discovered a new site on Phrygis.
True, we just left there.
There's also a Vulcan archaeologist, Shaynok, who's an expert on the Chodak. I'll attempt to contact him as well.
Oh, cool. I get to talk to Shaynok again. That'd be cool.
All right, Captain. Good luck. Williams out.
Not sure why I like Shaynok.
What are your orders, Captain?
I think we're supposed to go to Shonoiso Epsilon 6? Isn't Horse 3 the planet with all the different animals and the biotopes? I think we're supposed to go to Shonoiso Epsilon 6. Can I change it to Warp 8 or something?
Lay in a course for Shonoiso Epsilon 6, Warp 5.
Aye, sir.
Sensors are picking up a vessel.
Uh-oh. Screw it. Get us out of here.
Get us out of here.
Aye, aye, sir.
Engage.
Yeah, I didn't click that. I almost did.
Go to red alert. A Romulan warbird is on sensors. Locking weapons. We are being hailed.
Hail.
Do you need a moment, Captain? I understand you humans need to pray before death.
Oh, brother. You guys have hardly any weapons. Surrender or just self-destruct, whatever you're gonna do. A fight is in nobody's best interest.
You know as well as I that our ships are evenly matched. A fight is in nobody's best interest.
Actually, you're probably less than evenly matched at this point. Unless they're one of the Romulan vessels who have not stripped of their weapons. Which, I mean, we haven't scanned them, so we don't know, right?
I am very much interested in a fight, Captain. The destruction of the Enterprise will be a great boost to my career.
It won't be any career if you're dead.
Torpedo locked. Direct hit. We have been hit.
Savor your victory while you can, Captain. You will find it short-lived.
I think my DOSBox settings are way too high. That should have lasted more than a second and a half.
Fire.
Torpedo away. The shields are holding.
Get him, Worf. Oop. You got him. So going into warp didn't stop anything from happening.
The Romulan warbird has been destroyed.
Indeed.
Alert.
What? Alert what?
Go to red alert.
Another? I thought it was about to tell us there was another ship. Oh, there's our tactics and stuff. So we are not damaged.
Captain, an urgent message is coming in from Chancellor Larocque of Fridges.
Ah, Chancellor Larocque. Larocque.
On screen.
Captain Ky'Dra, a Romulan warbird has invaded our system. You promised to defend us. Please come as quickly as you can.
Okie dokie. Hold up.
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
I'm guessing we're not in real time now when we're doing this. When we're in this. Outposts? Oh, so I can't directly warp there?
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain,
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
Oh, God.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should...
We need to go to Fridges.
Admiral Williams here.
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Your orders are to investigate the real reasons behind the Romulan incursion.
Mm-hmm.
Picard out.
Alright, astrogation. Oh, Fridges. Are we here? I'm not sure if we're here.
Engage.
Oh, okay. We're headed there.
Warning. Entering nebula.
I'm kind of worried we took too long after he said that. Probably not, but... I'll make an 18-2 save.
Entering Federation space.
Going back to Phrygis. Again.
Captain's log supplemental. We have arrived at Phrygis in response to a distress call from Chancellor Larac. Although he claims to have been attacked by the Romulans, we can find no evidence that any battle ever took place.
Sensors are picking up a vessel.